First African-American female strip club owners in the state of California. Yes. And I said, well, you know, it takes a lot with the zoning and the liquor licenses and everything like that. I said, well, I want to have a strip club that's going to, you know, really be popular that people are going to really want to come to, because I do at the end of the day want to make money. I want to have a strip club that's going to reflect my own personality. And so I said, well, what am I going to do to have a strip club that everybody's going to want to go to? I said, well, I'm going to have all the strippers in my club. They're going to all weigh 165 and up. Yeah, we're not going to go high, but we got some tricks, you know. And I already have a name picked out for my strip club. It's going to be called Beefies. And the pole isn't going to be your normal regulation size pole, obviously. It's going to be a little sturdier. It's going to be by the side of the telephone pole. We ain't going to be doing all that spinning around. Y'all already seen all that. We're just going to kind of walk around and be like, ooh, it's hot in here. You know, our lap dance is gonna kind of go more like this. Hey! You gotta pay $65 to get up off you. You know, Dr. Jones, I was very hesitant about wearing this dress today for the same reason why I do not sit up front at the church. I've never met a girl who could cross my leg properly. I think because I have such a big personality, I'm never able to cross my leg. But you know, I love church. Y'all remember when your grandma and them used to listen to that AM radio church broadcast? Loud and mother, distorted. And they're like, why don't you turn this shit down? They'd be like, and the last of the church. I do believe we ought to be able to bring our own wine.